Just 158 kilometers north of Vancouver lies Pemberton, BC, a small but bustling town known for its proximity to Whistler, its stunning natural beauty, and its endless outdoor adventures. Hi there, I'm Sarah Wright, and I'm your host for Where You Live. Today we're highlighting the downtown core of Pemberton. We're gonna talk to the mayor, we're gonna check out some shops, all that and more coming up on this Pemberton edition of Where You Live.
Pemberton's big. There's so much to see and experience. It'll punch you in the mouth. It's like putting the best day of your life in your mouth and eating it. It's huge here. It's huge.
Knowles is referring to the experiences Pemberton has to offer, not the population of around 2,600. And until 1966, when Highway 99 extended to Pemberton, there was less than 200 residents.
The only way you could come to Pemberton back in the day was by train. It was one way in and one way out.
The Sea to Sky Highway sees more and more traffic every year, with the seed potato capital of North America becoming quite the destination.
It's always changing. I've seen Pemberton change from a town of dirt roads to every square bit of it pretty well is paved, and a lot of logging, a lot of agriculture. But it's slowly changing over to a tourism-based economy. Pemberton is a great place to visit if you love the outdoors. It's got a little bit of the city, but it's got a lot of wilderness. If you like hiking, camping, fishing, there's lots of big mountains that are in your face and lush. It's lush green and lots of wildlife. So, I mean, any given day you can see wildlife.
Tourism Pemberton is determined to keep both locals and visitors happy.
It's a small group of people that are passionate about the success of Pemberton. The thing with Pemberton's tourism board is that it's no one's getting paid on it. So, I mean, at that point, you get people that really care about the community and how well it does.
Through agriculture and forestry peaks to the rise in tourism, the backbone of Pemberton has always been its residents.
People that live in Pemberton are easygoing people. Straight up, people that like being around other people, they're outdoorsy people, and they're friendly. Everybody kind of knows everybody, and you drive down the road and you can wave to pretty well everybody and they'll wave right back. So it's kind of one of those places that still have that feeling of community, you know?
What better way to start an episode all about downtown Pemberton than to speak to the mayor himself? So here we are with Mayor Mike Richmond. Thanks so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
So remind us, how long have you lived in Pemberton?
I lived in Pemberton since around 1991, so about 26 years.
So safe to say you're loving it.
Absolutely.
When you talk to friends or family from out of town, do you find yourself almost like bragging about how great this community is?
Totally. I think people get sick of me doing it, actually. But I think it's for good reason. I don't say it because I'm the mayor or anything like that. I think Pemberton truly is a really special town. We've got a combination of elements here that I don't think you find anywhere else, really. And by that, I mean our small town living. We have a lot of those small town qualities here. The sense of community is incredible here. But having said that, we have a sophistication and a diversity. I think that comes from being close to Whistler and Vancouver. But we have a diversity that you don't find, I'd say, in most small towns. And I've traveled a lot of small town BC and Quebec and other parts of Canada. So I think it really is, you know, everything we have to offer geographically, the community itself, the opportunities, it's just, yeah, it's second to none.
And what about like the downtown core here in Pemberton? How special and how important is that area?
Downtown core is super important. I mean, the downtown is not only your commercial core, but it's the heart of your community. And so I think, you know, your downtown, ultimately you would like it to represent the personality or the identity of your community itself. So I think it's the social heart as well as the commercial heart of the community. So downtown's super important, and keeping it healthy and vibrant is very important to us.
What's it like for newer businesses starting up there, such as, say, Stay Wild, the new health store?
You know, it's interesting because there's always going to be challenges here in the sense that we, you know, again, down the road we have Whistler and many name brand stores. You go a little further down the road to Squamish and you've got the box stores. So on a retail, from a retail perspective, competition is always tough, you know, when you have that access to those opportunities. Having said that, we're seeing a lot of growth in our population. There's a real desire from a lot of residents to shop locally wherever they can. So the locals are very loyal to their local business people. But it's certainly not easy. It is still a fairly small market, and you are competing with some really strong markets not far away. So,
you've been in office for 2 years now. How has the community changed since you've gotten in there?
You know, it's interesting. Over the years, I was a businessman in Pemberton for 15 plus years, and then a contractor, whatever. But I've seen a ton of growth. When I moved here, there was like 500 people or 700 people, whatever it was. And over the years, Pemberton has this sort of life cycle where it seems we go through great big jumps in our growth, and then we level off for a while, and then it jumps, and then we level off. And we're going through one of those right now. By our standards, there's a lot of development going on and a lot of interest in development. There are housing issues up and down the corridor, so part of that is the market reacting to those housing shortages. But we're going to see a lot of new residents coming in over the next little while, so that's obviously going to change the environment a little bit in the business community and hopefully, you know, give people more opportunity.
Big event here in Pemberton is Pemby Fest. How does that affect the town, the community, everything like that?
You know, I'm glad you asked it, because it's always a tough one for us to manage. You get an event like the Pemberton Music Festival that comes in, brings in 40-some thousand people to an area of 5,000 plus, it's a huge impact. And the economic impact is undeniable. There's millions of dollars that are spent in the area and in the province. So it's our job to be able to balance those economic impacts with social impacts, environmental impacts. Because there are people that love the festival, there's others not so much. So again, we have to find, as a council and village, find that balance that, again, the economic impacts help all of us. Social environmental impacts, whether it's anything from, you know, the disposal of garbage to safety and road traffic to protecting our rivers and our lakes to environmental lands, all those things are super important to us. And we got to find a way to hold this event. We try to find that balance to hold the event so that those things are looked after, and while the area could still benefit economically. So it's a ton of work for our staff, you know, being able to put that event on, and it's a lot of work.
But probably worth it.
It is worth it. Again, there's times you question it, you know, and it's interesting when I have this conversation with residents, some of the things I like to remind us, or one of the things I like to remind ourselves about is, you know, we look at it every now and again and go, the amount of work, the amount of impact, oh, wouldn't it be easier if it just went away? And that's an easy attitude to take when things are good. And we're in a good economic place right now. There's a lot of growth in the area. The economy takes another downturn. I think we'll be happy to see those dollars rolling into our community once a year. So I think you got to be able to look at the whole picture when you're looking at an event like this.
Well, there's always going to be someone on this side and someone on that side. Just like one of the recent things that came up with council, with Pemberton decided to put in the bylaw restricting or not allowing distributing marijuana operations. Mm-hmm. How did council come to that decision?
So there's a few things to that. So first of all, I mean, that's an interesting one, because that's one of those items that where there's a lot of layers to it, and people tend to focus on one of the layers. So what I mean by that is council is not philosophically opposed to the retail of medical marijuana.
Right.
A few months or over a year ago or so, the federal government gave us some regulations and some guidance as to how to regulate the growth of medical marijuana. We then did some zoning, and we've allowed it in our industrial park.
Right.
In this case, when it comes to the retail of medical marijuana, the federal government has not given us that guidance. They have said in the next few months they will come out with those regulations, those guidance. It's a big one for small communities to be able to deal with right now, because essentially, in the eyes of the law, it's still illegal to retail marijuana. If you need medical marijuana, you go through the Canada Post and all that sort of thing. So it's still an illegal activity. So for us, in our bylaw, we can't supply business licenses for an illegal operation.
Right.
So it creates all this gray area and confusion. Now, on top of that, the village, we've decided that this year we're going to engage in the process of reviewing our entire zoning bylaw, as well as our sign bylaw. It's been over 15 years, I think, since we've done our zoning bylaw. And what that means is we're going to look at the zoning right across the boundaries.
Okay.
We're going to look at, is it still appropriate? Does it still make sense? Do growth nodes, are they the same? You know, do you still want the same combinations of zonings on certain areas around town? So we want to look at the whole town. To be cost effective about this, we wanted to do the whole thing at once.
Right.
As opposed to piecemealing it. So the zoning of medical marijuana retail will be included in that review. So the reason council came to the decision that we would in the short term prohibit the retail of medical marijuana is we felt that through the zoning process we could do a much more thorough approach.
Okay.
And B, by the time we get to that in a couple of months, hopefully the feds have given us the guidance and the regulations surrounding that so we could properly apply them within our zoning and make sure that the retail medical marijuana is done properly within our boundaries. What does that look like? There's towns that are doing, you know, drawing circles going 300 meters from schools and all that sort of thing. You know, if you took some of those regulations, you'd pretty much zone out the whole town. So we've got to make sure these things apply to our town, our residents, the size of our town. How does it work? Where does it belong? Those sorts of questions we still have to answer.
So you guys have a plan for the future when it comes to that. But in general, how are you feeling about the future of Pemberton?
I think the future of Pemberton is really bright.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot of growth in the area, so we're going to have to manage that growth, make sure the growth and the development lines up with our identity, reflects what we want, you know, what our values are as a community. I think a certain amount of growth is inevitable with the beautiful area we live in and the population growing and coming up the corridor. So again, I think it's up to us to make sure that that growth and that development happens in a way that we're comfortable with and that makes sense to our town and our residents. But I think that brings a lot of opportunities, and I think that our community continues to grow. We have a great young community, vibrant community where people are very involved, so I see the community getting stronger and stronger.
Speaking of involved, you yourself are, many people know you're very involved with sports. You like to coach. I hear there's an event coming up that you kind of take care of for yourself.
Sure, I'll take an opportunity to plug that. I'm a coach at the high school. Girls basketball.
Yeah.
Been there about 10 years. And this will be our second annual event. It's called the Day of the Devils because our team name is the Red Devils, Pemberton Red Devils. And just to give a little backstory to it, basically for rural towns, it's a challenge for our sports teams. Number one, we're reliant on volunteers for coaches. Number two, we travel for everything.
Yeah.
So the costs mount really quickly in terms of travel costs. We go to tournaments as far as Barrier, as far, you know, we go Valemont, all over the province, right? So the travel costs, ferry costs, motel costs, food costs, tournament costs, they add up a lot.
Yeah.
And the only way we can compete with some of these bigger schools is if we're getting that kind of game time. So there's a lot of money spent by parents on their kids just to keep us in sports. So this is called the Day of the Devils. It's our second one of many to come. There's a group of us that organize it. There's a casino, there's a golf tournament. It's April 29th. Casino, golf tournament, there's a dance. We have Dakota Pearl playing this time. And myself and a handful of other local chefs get together, put on a big feast. The beef is provided by a local farmer.
Nice.
So it's all community. Once again, it's all community. Last year we raised, I think, over $20,000. I might be wrong on that, but it was a good chunk of money for our sports team, so it's awesome. And it's one of many fundraisers and community-driven groups and events that we have here. So yeah, April 29th.
Sounds like a great event for the whole family and the whole community.
It will be.
Well, thanks so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
I look forward to seeing the growth of Pemberton.
Come on back.
We're going to take a quick little break here, but don't go anywhere. Things are about to get wild on Where You Live. Welcome back to this Pemberton edition of Where You Live. And like I said earlier, things are about to get wild because we're inside the new natural health store, Stay Wild, with owners Nada and Leah. Thanks so much for joining me today, ladies.
Thanks for coming.
So this episode is all about downtown Pemberton. What's so great about this area in particular?
Pemberton's awesome. I mean, when we look out our windows, we can see Mount Currie right there, which is a beautiful way to start the day. Beautiful lakes and everything around here. It's a nice small community. We're really close to Whistler, so we have all the advantages of Whistler, but we get to live small town life, which is awesome.
For sure. Take me back now. How did Stay Wild all start?
Stay Wild came together after we had the fire at my old store, Be Natural. We closed about a year ago due to a fire, and I wasn't sure at the time if I was going to be able to reopen. And then Leah approached me about collaborating on this together. And yeah, here we are.
It looks great. Where did the name come from? Stay Wild.
We were talking about the name Be Natural and whether or not we were going to keep it or not. And Nada's name on Facebook and Instagram and email and everything was always Stay Wild. And I kind of just approached her and said I was thinking that it might be the perfect name for the store, and she liked it. And that's what we have.
It's short and sweet, easy to remember. So talk to me about the staff. Is everyone situated here in Pemberton?
Yeah, we have about 10 staff right now, including ourselves. So all of us are based in Pemberton, with the exception of we have a community herbalist who commutes 2 days a week to be up here with us. And then we also have one of our full-time staff in the juice bar who lives up at Lillooet Lake.
Cool. Let's talk about you two now. Close friends, opening a business, running a company together. What's the dynamic like there?
It's been really good. We've made mistakes and we've had our problems here and there with just figuring out opening a business. But when it comes to it, we both have a lot of experience in different sectors, and we've kind of brought all our strengths towards each other. And yeah, it's going really well.
So you'd say you benefit from having that good friendship more than it challenges you?
For sure. Definitely.
That's awesome. So what is it about Pemberton that made you think, you know what, I got to open up a natural health store?
Well, I had a natural health store here for about 5 years. And then after the fire, it really became more apparent than ever that the community was missing it and that there was a huge void here for something like that. There's a lot of people here as well that are really focused on healthy, outdoor, active lifestyles. And I think there's a big demand for the type of food and groceries and stuff that's sort of the healthy, organic alternatives.
So Pemberton is a close-knit communities, so is the whole Sea to Sky. So when someone is in need, people love to help out, and it's no different for Stay Wild, right?
Yeah, we're putting together a couple things right now. Right, we have a charity going for our friend Shannon Flanagan at the moment. She's battling stage 4 cancer, and so we're doing a little fundraiser for her, and we plan on continuing to do that for people in the community, not necessarily people that we know, but just people that are living in the Pemberton area, and try to help them and their families out as much as we can.
That's really nice of you guys. Good luck raising funds for Shannon and anyone else that's going to need them, and thanks for chatting with us today. Have fun keeping Pemberton healthy.
Thanks for coming.
All right, so next up on Where You Live, we're talking potatoes, but not the ones you eat. Stay tuned. Hi there, you're watching Where You Live only on Shaw TV, and today we're in downtown Pemberton. Living in a small town can come with its challenges and its benefits, and we want to find out how businesses keep up and running while dealing with those challenges. So let's head inside Small Potatoes Bazaar. So we're with Sweeta inside Small Potatoes Bazaar, the owner here. Small Potatoes Bazaar, where on earth did that name come from?
Well, small potatoes, because Pemberton is actually the potato seed capital of Canada.
Oh, so it's perfect.
So we grow virus-free potatoes here. And bazaar, I never wanted to be limited to what I could carry.
And how did it all start?
Well, I worked in the retail and service industry in Whistler for many years. And I always ended up in supervisory or managerial positions. So I was essentially a entrepreneur, if you have it, before I became an entrepreneur, so yeah.
And what's it like for someone to open a new business here in a small town like Pemberton, make it thrive, and what kind of person does it take to make this happen?
Well, it's tough because there's only 2,200 people here.
Yeah.
So it's very tough, and you know, there's different incomes as anywhere, but here it's more limited. But if you love what you do, it's not work.
Yeah. So you love what you do. Is that what keeps you going year after year with this? I mean, it's challenging in the small town, right?
Totally, it is. And so doing it year after year, you wanna work smarter, you know, do better. And you do that by, you know, analyzing what are we doing, what's working, what's not working. You want to be on trend. You want to listen to your customers, what they're looking for.
And one way to bring in customers is stay out in the community. So you guys get involved in some community events? fundraisers, stuff like that?
Yeah, we donate quite often to lots of different community events. We even participate and help out, like with the father-daughter dance or different things. Just recently I donated to the Brownies, had three, you know, asked for help, but you know, you can only do so much, and we do whatever we can to help out.
And were you saying you were part of the high school program here in Pemberton?
Yeah, we work with the high school here, and what they're looking for is work experience, so the high schoolers, they can go out and get a job. And so you want to train those students on, you know, work ethic and how to be a multitasker and basically how to become a mature young adult, right?
Perfect. Yeah. And that's how you can help to grow the community, because Pemberton is obviously growing a lot right now.
Yeah, and hopefully, you know, like they, if they're successful in their time here, and it does take a lot of time on our part, you know, training and helping and nurturing, and, you know, hopefully we can offer them employment.
Well, it's a great way to give back.
Totally.
Well, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you.
Thanks for tuning in to this Pemberton edition of Where You Live, and thanks again to our guests on the show today. If you'd like to learn more about what we do here at Shaw TV, give us an email at seatosky@sjrb.ca, and of course you can always follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Shaw TV Sea to Sky. For Shaw TV, I'm Sarah Wright. We'll see you next time.